When this generation of CPAs dies off, what's the next generation of CPA firm going to look like?
Wow, that's a great question. I think there will be two classes. There will be the large mega firm that we see that's developed today, and I think there will be very small, very boutique, very focused firms. I think if you're not one of those two, it's going to be very difficult. Our firm in particular is very focused. We only do some things. We really don't do audits to speak of. We've really got out of that business, but we do very sophisticated tax work. We do a lot of real estate work. We do a lot of forensic accounting work. We do those things well. What we don't do well is bookkeeping. What we don't do well is compilations for the corner grocery store. So I think you're going to see continuous specialization of these firms into very boutique areas because it's just pure market driven. At the end of this whole process, right, you can only charge what the market will bear, and if you bring specialized technical knowledge to a particular problem, you can afford to charge more. What's the difference between a Rolex watch and the watch on your hand and an Apple Watch? It'll keep time, right? So the difference between the two of them is perception of the value, what you're getting. People perceive the Rolex to be the high-end watch with a great quality and a look and a feel, but it doesn't keep time any better than anything else. So why are these important, these ideas? Because you want to specialize your product into something that's hard for other people to compromise. Nobody's going to beat me and my expertise in real estate because I'm a real estate owner-operator. I know the business. Nobody's going to go ahead and do better forensic work than me because I have 30 years experience in the area. These are unique qualities that people can't duplicate. So firms that follow that path, I think, are going to be very successful. Firms that offer vanilla-based products are going to be in trouble because you never can be the low-cost provider. And if it's nothing specialized, somebody will come along with specialized knowledge and that client will drift away to those firms. So I think that's what you see. Very large mega firms, very specialized boutique firms.